Welcome to the lecture on catalytic organometallics. This is already part 12. In the preceding lesson, we discussed the Wacker oxidation, where an olefin is activated by palladium chloride or another palladium II salt for the attack of a nucleophile. And within this Wacker process, it is necessary to reoxidize the palladium, since a palladium zero intermediate will occur, and the active catalyst, the electrophilic palladium, is in the oxidation state plus two. So what about having a diene instead of an olefin? So let's have a look. Butadiene as the simplest example indeed reacts with palladium chloride, and if we perform the reaction stoichiometrically in equilibrium, there will be a coordination of the palladium chloride at the butadiene, similar to what we know already from the reaction with a simple olefin. And an addition reaction or an insertion reaction takes place. A chloride is transferred to the terminus. Then, well, a palladium allyl complex is formed, maybe first eta 1, but then a palladium pi allyl complex. This dimerizes forming such a coordination dimer. And this turns out to be rather stable and can be isolated. In presence of acetic acid, then the corresponding product with the acetate functionality at the terminal CH2 group is isolated, of course, also as a dimer. We can perform such a reaction catalytically, but then we have to add, well, an oxidizing agent, and very often for these cases it's simply benzoquinone. Beckwald's group reported this type of reaction catalytically. They used as an interesting model compound, for instance, cyclohexadiene, the conjugated one. Palladium acetate as the catalyst. Acetic acid as solvent, or at least as part of a solvent. You need an oxidizing agent to run the reaction catalytically. Benzoquinone is very often used. Well, benzoquinone can oxidize palladium zero to palladium two, and itself it's reduced then to hydroquinone, of course. In that case, you will obtain a diacetate, this one. It's reported with a 79% yield. On the other hand, if you have enough additional nucleophile lithium acetate or lithium chloride, the result depends somewhat on the concentration, then you will obtain the cis product. It is reported with a 69% yield, initially from Beckwall. However, latest results from other groups where this has been applied in natural product synthesis reported up to 93% yield, while they used this material as starting material for first the diol, just hydrolyzation of the two ester groups, and then an epoxidation, almost interestingly, all oxygens then on the same side of the ring. And this has been then applied into natural product synthesis. Now to the mechanism. The cyclohexadiene coordinates to the palladium acetate. It's therefore activated for the attack of a nucleophile, an acetate, for instance, from acetic acid, which is just enough. And we will then form the allyl palladium complex with the palladium acetate on the other side of the ring. Initially, there are two acetate functionalities, acetate substituents at the palladium. This is then minus, of course. And one acetate is eliminated. Then we have this one. If there is no suitable nucleophile around, then after a while this can also decompose, transferring the acetate group intramolecularly. And we will get this acetate group on the opposite side. This is this result. If we have more nucleophile present, lithium acetate, or especially lithium chloride is very often used, then an exchange will take place . A palladium chloride intermediate, an allyl palladium chloride intermediate, is postulated. And then the acetate will attack from the opposite side of a ring and the other stereoisomer will be the result. Depending on the exact reaction conditions, also the chloride can work as the nucleophile, then we would have a chloride here on instead of the acetate group. We will see some examples of such a reaction later on. Well, next example is an example with the first nucleophile being presented intramolecularly, an interesting test substrate. Well, although racemic, same reaction conditions as discussed before, palladium acetate in catalytic amounts, the oxidizing reagent, usually benzophenone. So, again, the activation, but now we have this carboxylate group, the carboxyl group, here as the internal nucleophile. And what will happen? Well, it's a seven-membered ring. A lactonization will occur. With the palladium acetate on the other side of the ring. So, as I said, of course, acetic acid is present and sodium acetate or lithium acetate. If not enough external or not enough external nucleophiles are present, then the acetate group will be transferred intramolecularly. Again, palladium zero is formed, which then is reoxidized. Actually, this product was isolated with 58% yield. If we have additional lithium chloride, then this palladium acetate group will be transformed into an allyl palladium chloride, and acetate will attack then as a nucleophile from the other side of a ring and will be then located on the same side as the lactone. Therefore, we will get the other diastereoisomer, which is isolated in a 55% yield. And finally, well, having other nucleophiles present, it might be possible, and it is in some cases possible, to produce, in general, this type of product. Well, it should be clear that this reaction is not restricted to a seven-membered ring. Actually, it isn't restricted to ring systems at all. If you have a six-membered ring, in this case, the yield which has been obtained is even higher, 75% yield. And what we can say in general, let's assume having a diene this CH2 group might be present one, two, or three times, or even more. And we have a six, seven, and eight-membered rings. If n is zero, I think also with five-membered rings, it works. Might be that you get some problems in terms of cyclopentadienyl formation. However, we are working generally in more acidic conditions. That should not be a problem. And, well, the internal nucleophile must not necessarily be located here at this position. It can be somewhere. And, of course, we have various possibilities for that nucleophile. So this is then intramolecular nucleophile number one, and we can offer nucleophile number two, and overall the result should be this one then. Various applications and synthesis will become possible. So, one example for a target molecule. E is both an ester, so a malonate group has been introduced. This is the target molecule. So, and retrosynthesis according to that general scheme leads us to this cyclohexadiene with the alcohol functionality in the side chain, and this malonate we already know, for instance, from the Tsuchitrost reaction as a very nice nucleophile. The normal reactions for this oxidative transformation of butadienes is, as I said, well, acetic acid to some extent present, and that's the reason why this process now with a palladium catalyst won't work directly. Since we have acetic acid there, and what will happen, acetic acid plus the malonate, it gets protonated. So, therefore, the synthesis was a bit modified. Acetone, acetic acid in the ratio 4:1. Benzoquinone, catalytic palladium acetate, and lithium chloride in excess. To my knowledge, no additional lithium acetate or sodium acetate, or no additional nucleophile, then the result of this oxidative transformation will be this one with a chloride cis to the benzo tetrahydrofuranyl ring. Well, and indeed, this has been isolated with a 91% yield. Then, in the next step, a palladium zero catalyst was applied in THF with the malonate, well, that simply is the Tsuchitrost reaction. What will happen? Usually the palladium zero catalyst substitutes the chloride from the opposite side of that ring, and the nucleophile again is then introduced, substitutes the palladium also from the opposite side, and therefore overall the chloride is substituted under retention. This is the result, and this step works just excellent with a 98% yield reported. Benzyl carbamate same reaction conditions, just again palladium acetate catalytically lithium chloride benzoquinone acetone acetic acid 4:1, nitrogen acts as the nucleophilic center. Chloride introduced as the external nucleophile. This initial product was used for the synthesis of an interesting alkaloid. Well, the alkaloid is interesting from its structure, and it's interesting that it's readily accessible. It's just a toxic alkaloid with no use. But nevertheless, they can make it, so they did it. Next step is the reaction with this Grignard reagent under copper catalysis. We discussed this type of reaction last semester in terms of the copper catalyzed Wurtz coupling process. Well, okay, a cuprate is formed and will react in an SN2 prime reaction with this allylic chloride. Now we have this electron-rich benzene ring in close proximity to this electrophilic, highly electrophilic center. Well, it's not that highly electrophilic, but we can activate with phosphoroxychloride. Essentially, this is an electrophilic aromatic substitution. Plus some other reagents. You can also call it an intramolecular Friedel-Crafts type reaction. And last step, to finish the alkaloid synthesis, is to reduce the cyclic amide with lithium aluminum hydride. And certainly you know with lithium aluminum hydride, it's completely reduced until we have a CH2 group here. So this was the final product of the synthesis, and this natural product is called lycorain, for those who wish to look that up in the internet, for instance. Other nucleophiles, internal nucleophiles, which are possible for this type of reactions here, an allylic silane, which is of course also a nucleophile, same reaction conditions as before, again the introduction of a chloride, now of course a five-membered carbocycle is formed here, and the alkylated silyl group is eliminated, giving rise to a terminal olefin here, another stereogenic center. So the selectivity, the diastereo selectivity concerning those three centers is better than 98%, 68% yield is obtained, but it is still a mixture of diastereoisomers, 3:1, 3 is this one, and the one, so 25% of the diastereoisomer with the opposite stereochemistry at that stereogenic center. So here the difference to the examples we've studied before is that the tether starts right adjacent to that diene. And you're right, then a spirocycle should be formed. This is indeed the case. Ninety-eight percent diastereo selectivity in favor of this diastereo isomer. As final example of this type of reaction, we should have a look at an acyclic starting material. Here the butadiene, there an amide. Reaction conditions, in that case palladium acetate, a copper chloride oxygen combination, which we are used to from the Wacker process, THF 60 degrees. So what will happen? Finally, that nitrogen will react as the nucleophile, the diene is activated. We should have five-membered ring formation, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 centers. Well, and as you see, we have an allyl group here still somewhat nucleophilic center, nitrogen. And since this is intramolecularly offered, it can easily intercept intramolecularly this allylic complex, leading to this bicyclic heterocycle from acyclic compounds in just one preparative step with an excellent yield of 90%. This works very well also with a longer chain, one CH2 group more. Then you have a six-membered ring here, and reducing that carbonyl group again with lithium aluminum hydride, and you already have some really interesting alkaloids. Maybe you remember from the preceding lesson that we discussed this octadiene system with the acetate functionality in the Wacker process, Wacker oxidation as a model compound, and selectively the terminal olefin was oxidized, the terminal olefin preferentially, since it is less sterically hindered compared to the internal olefin. So now the question, how could you synthesize this octadiene system? Well, if you want to synthesize that, especially on an industrial scale, and it is synthesized on an industrial scale, we want to start with really cheap starting materials. Acetic acid is certainly one starting material we would like to use, and well, we need then 8 more carbons and 12 hydrogen atoms. And an interesting idea would be acetic acid plus 2 times C4H6, which is butadiene. Well, and indeed, this reaction works very well. Acetic acid plus 2 equivalents of butadiene, a palladium zero catalyst, usually phosphine ligands, the E isomer is obtained up to 76% yield. The Z olefin with 11% yield and this regio isomer with a 13% yield. Mechanism of this reaction. Palladium zero, the phosphine ligands, the phosphine ligands in equilibrium can coordinate or, well, it dissociates, and then butadiene can be coordinated, not only one, but also two equivalents. Now imagine a process where electron density from one butadiene will form a C-C bond here. So then we would get an allylic cation, a palladium pi allyl complex, and on the other hand, a palladium carbon sigma bond here. So this will result in such a complex. Let's count the carbon centers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is correct. If a nucleophile is offered with an acidic hydrogen, could be, for instance, an alcohol, or acetic acid, such in the case already discussed, then this eta 1 allyl complex is protonated here, this is cationic, and we have the nucleophilic nucleophile as the counter anion. Well, and this will then substitute the palladium. Leading to this final product. And as I said, this works with water, with alcohols, with acetic acid, with other acids. It works also with amines. And initially, this reaction was found with just phenol as the nucleophile. Reaction was found in 1967. So, this NU is O phenol then, obtained with 96% yield, and indeed a very robust reaction. It works with excellent yields in the temperature range of 0 to 150 degrees. I think this is remarkable. And this type of process is of course very interesting, for instance, in terms of atom economy. Just a bit of catalyst and all other atoms which are offered as reagents go into the final product, except of the salt. So I think it's a remarkable reaction, very useful, also very motivating to develop new ideas. I think this is enough for today. Tomorrow we will discuss some other oxidative palladium catalyzed reactions. We will focus on the palladium catalyzed oxidation of just CH bonds, which is of course connected with the important term CH activation. Thank you for listening. See you tomorrow.